of 1994, the Minnesota State High School League voted to accept a Sweet 16 basketball playoff format. This year, one state tournament, one state champion.
If we would somehow win the state championship, you know, that's, we'd be the best team in the state, you know, Class A, AA. That'd be the greatest thing. I'd rather, much rather have it combined.
There's a difference between A and AA, and there rightfully should be with the size of school, but yet the difference isn't as big as what people may perceive it to be. And I think that's true. And I think that, you know, given the opportunity, there's a number of Class A schools that could do some damage down there.
And that team may come from Section 6. Craig Starnes has won 389 games in his illustrious career and is looking for his second section title in 4 years with the Minnewaska Lakers. The Lakers will face one of the premier players in the state in Staples forward, Blaine Yeager. The Cardinals are the perennial power in Section 6, looking to their sixth championship game in 8 years. The Hillcrest Comets, champions of Subsection 3, carry the label of giant killers with a run of 3 straight upsets to claim the championship. Tonight, they're up against the biggest giant of them all, 6'10", Kevin Logie. And the number one ranked Morris Tigers. Morris has won off a 22-2 record and wants nothing less than a return trip to the state championship game. You are looking live inside a jam-packed Copper Fieldhouse. Concordia College, Moorhead, Minnesota. Good evening, everybody. Ed Schultz along with Denny Anderson and Dana Mock. This is the most talked about tournament in the section, in the state of Minnesota. Section 6A has developed a reputation of its own over the years because of the fantastic finishes. But the reputation it's putting forth this year is one of perennial players, one of them in Kevin Logie from the Morris Tigers. Denny, how good is this kid?
Well, he's an excellent player. And he's good enough where the University of Minnesota has already got him on a contract as a junior. So he's an outstanding player. We're in for one super night of basketball tonight.
The Hillcrest Comets playing with a great deal of emotion. They've got 19 wins, so they have a shot tonight.
Hillcrest is going to have to control the tempo. It would be just a Cinderella story if they could beat this team, because we've got Hillcrest with their outside game. And control, they're going to have to control the tempo, and then we've got Morris with an outside game and a super inside game. So they've got it all.
In our second game tonight, Staples against Minnewaska. But coming up next, we got a dandy matchup. It's Kevin Logie inside. It's the ace backcourt magic of Zach Witt. Corey Schmickdahl, tremendous performer. The number one ranked Morris Tigers up against the Hillcrest Comets. They outlasted Pelican Rapids 3 times at the buzzer on Friday night. Can the Cinderella story continue tonight here at the Copper Fieldhouse? That story begins to unfold next on WDAY. It is the most celebrated section tournament in all of Minnesota. And the only way to get to that point is to develop a reputation. These kids have done it in this part of the state. We've seen fantastic finishes. We've seen them go to the wire. We've seen the tears and the smiles. And this year, unlike any other, there is one team that has felt a lot of pressure. That is Mark Torgerson's Morris Tigers. They are ranked number one in the state. They are 22-2. For Dana Mock, this has been kind of a tough run, has it not, Dana?
Well, Ed and Denny, is if it's not tough enough to play with that number one ranking most of the year, the Tigers had 3 big distractions. Kevin Logie's recruiting pressures from the University of Minnesota, Zach Witt being recruited by both basketball and football schools, and Andy Tate finding out he'll move after this year and won't be around for next year, his senior season. But things are now coming together for Morris, because Zach Witt has signed with Mankato as a quarterback. Logie has verbally committed to the University of Minnesota. Tate's still moving, but now the Tigers can say, let's win one for Andy.
For the starting lineups tonight, let's go to the PA announcer, Nick Guida.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Memorial Auditorium on the campus of Concordia College. Tonight's first 6A boys basketball game features the Subsection 1 champions, the Morris Area Tigers, against the Subsection 3 champions, the Hillcrest Lutheran Academy Comets. And now for your starting lineups. First for the guest team on the board, the Morris Area Tigers. Starting at a guard, a 5'11 junior, number 10, Andy Tate. Starting at the other guard, a 6'1 senior, number 14, Zach Witt. Starting at a forward, a 6'3 junior, number 34, Corey Schmidgall. Starting at the other forward, a 6'3 senior, number 40, Jason Asmus. And starting at center, a 6'9 junior, number 44, Kevin Logie. The Tigers are coached by Mark Hargerson. And now for the home team on the board, the Hillcrest Lutheran Academy Comets. Starting at one guard, a 5'10 senior, number 30, John Murgy. Starting at the other guard, a 5'11 senior, number 32, Mike Olstad. Starting at forward, a 6 foot senior, number 45, Ryan Prosser. Starting at the other forward, a 6'3 senior, number 24, Nathan Carl. And starting at center, a 6'3 senior, number 55, Michael LaFay. The Comets are coached by Greg Preston.
To tonight's games. Coach, do you just give way to a talented player such as Logie and concede the fact that he's going to get his points? I think it's crucial for Hillcrest to keep LeVang in the ball game. They got to have somebody of comparable size going at him defensively.
It definitely is. You've got to contain him. If you don't contain him, this game will get carried away in a hurry.
Plus 10 on the rebounding margin for Morris. A lot of that is Logie.
Of the 78 points that Morris had on that on the screen, 68 of them scored by these starters out here.
And the tip comes off to Zach Witt. The Tigers control man-to-man defense right away for Hillcrest. Logie, he'll come out. That's got to be a dangerous place for him to play as far as the passing lanes are concerned. And right away, as Schmidtgall puts down the three-pointer.
As we said before, Morris got an outstanding inside game, but they've also got those three-point shooters. So they've got an inside and outside.
Nate Carl, whoa, quickly a block, and that was Schmidtgall with the block that time. And we've got a net problem, so Logie will straighten that out. No, they're going to let turn to Andy Tate to do it.
Schmidtgall is an outstanding jumper, outstanding leaper. Last year as a sophomore, he stuffed one in a game here.
John Berge will put it in play. He gets it back to Olstead. And he loses it to Andy Tate, and that is going to be a foul on Olstead. Not a good start for the Comets.
Morris threw the zone on, and he out of bounds under there. And with Big Logie there, they really spread that thing out.
Schmidtgall comes up and... all ball. Nice anticipation there.
Beautiful block.
Logie down low. Easy two for the big kid. Kevin Logie. Prize recruit for the U.
Oh, they've got their rhythm tonight.
Berge on the wing. Man-to-man defense for the Tigers. From the corner, LeVang, he's got to hit something early. And a rebound to Prosser. Prosser, a three-point ace to this team. LeVang back to Prosser. And Berge controls. On the wing, Olstead. Olstead's going to do something with it, and he's fouled. That's going to be on Andy Tate.
Hillcrest up to their old tricks that they used in the subsection. A little head fake and go to the basket with it.
Tell you what, they're just as quick as the Tigers. They've got some quickness.
They do. They've got very nice players out there. Their outside game is excellent.
Olstead with a chance to put... Comets on the board, and he does.
I talked to him after the subsection final. He was so disappointed that he missed that free throw towards the end. He's an 83% shooter, but you can't make them all. He just dropped two now.
Zach Witt against zone pressure for the Comets. Witt, an excellent ball handler, until he gets in the face of Burton, and this is Holstead, rejected by Witt, and that's going to be a foul on the guard for Morris.
I think they called that on. Yeah, they did call it on Witt. I was thinking it was on Chase. No, you can't be careless with the ball. Burton is a very good defensive player, and he just picked his pocket right there.
Good composure by Holstead to come up and get the bucket, and he's at three straight at the line, and that's the scoring for the Comets here in the early going. Make it four. Great concentration. It's a one-point game. So the zone pressure, this is what gave Rotze so much problems the other night.
This zone pressure is very effective because they've got very quick kids.
And another turnover. Almost. That time, Asmus almost lost it. Andy Tate. Back to Witt, back to Tate, looking for Logie. Levang is playing him pretty tough down low. They can't get it into him. They got to hit that hand on the pass. Asmus is going to put it off the glass and down. Jason Asmus.
Ed, I think I'm right. I think they're 3 for 3.
They are. The shot by Carl is no good. It's cleared away by Schmidgall.
I don't know if Coach wanted one that quick out of him because he said we want to control so they don't get too many shots.
Logie, almost unstoppable. He's got 4 of the Tigers' 9. And you're right. Greg Preston is saying, now, wait a second. Let's not
let them have the ball all the time.
Get some kind of offensive rhythm.
Yeah.
Now the 2-3 zone for the Tigers. This is Olstead. Good shot, but it wouldn't fall, and Schmidgall is off to a great start on the boards tonight. Zach Witt. Schmidgall. Not this time. Rebound off to Tate. Tate draws a crowd. Zach Witt on the baseline, reverse layup, followed by Logie.
I wonder if Zach didn't, the angle he had, it looked like he just threw it up there, kind of a pass up there, Ed.
It's a quick 7-point advantage for the Tigers, and we'll be back.
From the summer sunshine to the first white winter snow, from the browns and golds of autumn to the spring when the rivers flow, a friendly welcome's waiting when I stop and say hello. Pelican Rapids sure can make you feel at home.
Welcome home.
Pelican Rapids sure can make you feel at home.
Kevin Logie showing Denny great anticipation here.
Yeah, he plays out on the floor some here. He doesn't just stick around the bucket, but there he was out on the floor and he just followed up that shot. And he's got a great nose for the game. There's Morris, 5 for 7 for the game. Hillcrest
getting all their points at the free throw line here, and that was 4 free throws by Mike Olstead. So we're halfway through this first quarter, and the Comets have yet to find the range. Carl, Berge for 3. The tip comes out to Berge again. He'll get this one. Nice follow by the 4-point student, John Berge. I kind of had an idea he was a smart one after we interviewed him the other night. What a poised young man.
You said that after the interview, yeah.
I was just, our whole crew was talking about it.
Well, if you're a youngster out there, boy or girl, and you want to play basketball or play any athletics, make sure you hit the books, because I'll tell you what.
Denny, you can't emphasize that enough. Kids can write their own ticket. Berge, and then Andy Tate gets it back for the Tigers.
Threw up there.
Well, I think it's pretty safe to say that Logie has brought the level of play of his players around him to a new level.
That's
you know,
right.
You get better when you play with somebody like that.
That's exactly right.
A 7-point lead for the top-ranked Tigers. You're watching the number one-ranked team in the state of Minnesota, Class A basketball. 22-2. Hillcrest at 19-4.
Boy, have they got this zone spread out. They're way out on the floor. They're not going to let them shoot threes out there.
Selvig.
Yet they got the big guy inside.
Carl. Hillcrest is getting the shots. They're just not falling. Quickly up the floor, Andy Tate, the Logie. He has not missed a shot, and he's got 10 points.
What do you want out of a big guy, Ed? You want him to be a good, have good hands. You want him to run the floor. There's a case of him running the floor.
Olstead with a basketball against the zone. David Selvig, he goes cross-court out to Berge. This is Berge, it won't go. Comes off to Logie again. And Morris continues to dominate with a 9-point lead. Make it 11 with a great move by Zach Witt.
That was a big-time guard move, let me tell you. He made a great move there.
This is Olstead. And I know that Comet fans feared being overwhelmed in this game. They've had their shots, and this is Olstead, and he is here. He has got all of the Comets' points.
Well, I think Berge got one, Ed. Got a bucket in there, but...
That's right, he did.
Yeah, but Olstead looks like he's got his confidence tonight, and he's sticking him up there, so he's an excellent shooter.
9-point advantage for the top-ranked Tigers. Andy Tate back out to Witt. Tate for three. His first points of the night.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you, and the youth out there, these kids have been ranked number one. They deserve it. Boy, can they play the game.
Levang. And Levang finds nothing but net. Still a 9-point advantage for the Tigers. And it's been, because of the shooting percentage, it's been an effortless 9-point lead. And here's Logie going to the bench with 10 points. He has not missed a shot.
Morris is very, very quick. They're very quick. I think, you know, we look, okay, they got Logie, but boy, they have got quickness on that floor.
Boots is now in for the Morris Tigers. This is Witt. Smith-Gall off to Andy Tate. Down to a minute. 5 remaining here in the first quarter.
I like Tate. The way they fake with that ball.
And Asmus can't get it to go, and off the bench comes Joel Scheid. He had an excellent subsection 3-6-A tournament. Prosser, known for the threes, dishes out to Scheid. Olstead, 10-point lead for the Tigers. Prosser for three, won't go. And we've got a foul that's going to be on Selvig.
Big rebound for Asmus. Very good jumper.
Hillcrest doesn't look timid. They don't look nervous.
They're just missing their shot.
Yeah,
they're right there, but you know, they're
on
right
the iron
there.
Too.
Yep, they are.
Zach Witt, nice feed. Boots, easy two. Tigers with a whole bunch of weapons.
It's just very difficult to beat good passing. You're going to get good shots with good passing.
Olstead for three. Yes. Mike Olstead, who had 20 points in 3 quarters of play the other night, and Witt almost put it off the iron. So at the end of one, it belongs to the Tigers, and we'll be back. That's just on the baseline. You got to get here early if you want a seat in the front row. Both ends of the court, just like that. Logie has not missed. Morris 10 of 14 as a team. Logie 5 of 5, averaging 66% from the field, and it's 22-13.
Hillcrest has got to feel good about being only down 8 when Morris is shooting like that. And Hillcrest, they're getting good shots. They're just not hitting them.
Olstead. Levang, 3 seconds. Olstead had the shot and didn't take it. I don't know if you can do that in tight against this team that often.
No, he was intimidated. Oh, Logie's awful big.
Tate. Zach Witt.
Ed even looks big from here, and
yeah,
we're not under him like these guys are.
Misses his first shot, and the rebound comes off to Hillcrest. Olstead off to Berge. Berge running the show.
Great hustle on that rebound.
Carl. Notice how the Tigers cover it up quickly on the outside. When you get the ball on the wing, you got to decide pretty soon what you're going to do with it. Selvig.
He'll take the baseline if they're going to give it to him.
And it's
made
now,
a great shot.
Now down to 7. Andy Tate. He's hit 1-3 tonight. Zach Witt. Oh, that's an inside-outside game again. Witt for 3. They double-teamed Logie at the low post, front and back, and then you got a guy hitting a 3.
Yeah, they've got it all, no doubt. This is the kid I think that Hillcrest has to have shooting the ball better.
Olstead?
And that is Carl.
Carl?
He just did not score very much in the subsection, and he's an outstanding scorer. He's 14-15-point average for the year.
Dana, confidence had to be high in the Tigers' huddle there at the quarter break.
Mark Torgerson had no complaints offensively or defensively. He did stress, don't let up. We need to build on this lead.
They try to go inside. They deny Logie that time. Witt in the corner. Back outside Schmickdahl. And again, Logie, and he's going to get the three-point play opportunity.
He's very quick for a big kid. He's got the good hands. He runs the floor. That was a quick drop step. Look at this drop step. He made it into a drop step by just heading for the bucket, exploding to the bucket.
Denny, you've been around several decades and then some here in Minnesota basketball. Coached over at Morehead State. You've been at a number of different levels. Where does this kid rank with like a Mark Oberding, who had such a phenomenal career out of Minnesota?
Well, yeah, Mark was so physical. He was such a horse. And of course, Logie here has a chance to develop some more because Kevin's only a junior, see, and he's going to have to put some weight on, and he's going to have to develop that way. But he's got the hands of those big people. And when we talk Oberdeen, we're talking a kid at 19 years old, went to the NBA. So it's really hard to compare against him. I'd say he's one of the best big men that this area has seen.
And it's going to stay with the Comets. That in itself is a heck of a compliment. And he's still growing.
That's right. That was a beautiful block right there. He's got great timing, great jumping ability.
Carl. Rejected by Logie. It comes off to Zach Witt. Witt. He will play quarterback at Mankato State. He is signed with Dan Runkle and the Mavericks. This kid's a heck of an athlete.
Oh, he's outstanding. He's explosive.
Scheid. Olstead. They're even coming out to take that 3 away. Scheid into the corner. Carl. Nice pass inside to Levang.
Beautiful pass.
Nice entry from Olstead on the wing. That'll give them a little confidence. They don't all have to be three-point shots. And Zach Witt.
He is so confident with the ball. He just takes it in there.
Has the same expression on his face the entire time, doesn't he?
Yes.
Scheid. Too strong. Levang again. Levang has got 6. staying within reach, but still a tall order for the Comets. Witt over to Asmus.
Michael, stick on it.
Andy Tate has hit a couple of threes already. Great patience by this Morris team.
Excellent patience.
Shy with the steal. Shy, he's fouled. He'll go to the line for two. And that's going to be on Schmigdahl.
We've got such quickness in the guards out here. Scheid is very, very quick. Morris's Witt and Tate are just unbelievably quick. Ulstead is quick. Bergie is quick. I mean, there's a lot of quickness out here.
Dana, I think that the demeanor of Hillcrest is the same it was in the tournament the other night. They're not starstruck at all. They just got to hit some shots.
They were starstruck in pregame warmups, though, when they watched about six different Tigers slam dunk. That can be intimidating for anybody.
Well, I tell you, Dana, that's see, the refs are supposed to be out here. They're not supposed to be able to do that.
There's a timeout on the floor.
It's an 11-point lead for the top-ranked Tigers. And we'll be back. You're watching Minnesota 6A semifinal action on WDAY.
Congratulations to all the teams from Hillcrest Academy in Fergus Falls. Hillcrest, a private boarding school with students in grades 9 through 12 from 18 states and 4 foreign countries, offers a Christian education. Bible study and chapel are part of every school day. Hillcrest is fully accredited, featuring a college prep curriculum. Music includes band and choir, travel opportunities, private instrumental and voice lessons. Students at Hillcrest enjoy participation in a full sports program. For more information, contact Hillcrest Lutheran Academy.
Here's the athletic ability of Zach Witt, going to play quarterback in football at Mankato State. That's great body control, Coach.
Oh, and he's got such confidence. He goes in there and he's not worried. He's not going to lose the ball. He's got great hands, quick hands, great dribbler, and he explodes. And then, of course, when you do get in trouble, you throw it up in the air and the big guy goes after it.
Those are some pretty fat numbers from the field for the Tigers. Those are seasonal numbers there, folks. Witt, 57% from the field. Logie, of course. Does he have an outside shot? We haven't seen it tonight.
He hasn't had to do it.
2-3 zone now for the Comets. Andy Tate out to Witt. Tate again in the corner looking for Logie. They double him up. Can't leave him alone. He's very dangerous from the corner. This time it won't go, and it's going to go to the Comets. Let's go to Dana Mock.
Ed Denny, I was in the Hillcrest huddle that time, and it has switched from Logie to Tate, and now the concern is Zach Witt. And even when the Comets play their 2-3 defense, Greg Preston telling his guards, you have to play Witt like you're in a man-to-man because he can penetrate so well.
Levang trying to get Logie out away from the bucket. Scheid. Scheid. His first two. With 3:07 remaining in the first half, Comets draw with a 9. 448 teams in Minnesota started the season. 64 teams remain tonight. The lefty, and that is going to be a rejection, but a foul on Nate Carl. Denny,
I think Hillcrest is getting out of that press what they want, except for Witt driving through it. When he goes through it, they're playing 5-on-3.
You know, this Sweet 16 tournament format they have at the state tournament this year, and Morris ranked number one in Class A. How do you rank them with the double A teams that you've seen around the state? Are we watching arguably the best team in the state?
It's a real possibility. I am really pulling. If they're going to get through this thing, then I'm really going to pull for them like crazy, because I tell you what, I have really been for that proposal for a long time. We have been pushing for that and pushing for it.
Witt on the putback, on the rebound, and he'll go to the line off the foul again, and that'll be the 15th foul here on the Comets in the first half, 3 on the Tigers.
Witt showed some real jumping ability there yet. I don't know what ability he doesn't have. I mean, he's got it all.
Why do you like that one class system, Denny, when you get down to the last 16 teams?
Well, it's a matter of interest in the game, and you got the David and Goliath thing, and it's been excellent in the past when we had it, and it just makes for a much better tournament. I think a big thing is in this, to get to the state tournament is a big thing.
And this is going to be a big bucket for Andy Tate. Tate has got 8 on the night. And back up by 14 goes Morris.
And we haven't changed that with the format because there are 8 A teams going to get in there and 8 AA, so we haven't changed that to get into the state.
Well, you've seen the celebrations here at this facility over the years that we've seen when teams win a region and section championship. They're not denied any emotion.
That's just true. But you know what's happened in the past few years? The team that gets out of here, it's kind of anticlimactic. They go down there and play to 5,000 people for their first game, you know, and this place is packed. I mean, this is the greatest tournament in Minnesota, no doubt, you know. We go from the subsection to the region here.
Logie, the world is covering him, and it doesn't matter.
Very quick moves, very quick moves. I'm sure that has to be the impressive thing why Minnesota gave him a contract already. Ed. He's so quick for a big kid.
They're a good-looking team when they put boots in there at forward with him, too.
Wow. He's a 6'5 kid.
Carl. Oh, he had to get that one up quick. Nice play by Nate Carl.
Nice move.
His first two of the night. And Mark Torgerson, he wants a timeout. So with a minute 22 remaining, not taking anything for granted, up by 14, the Tigers will burn a timeout, and you'd have to think there's probably a little bit of pressure on the shoulders of Mark Torgerson, coaching in a small town anywhere in America with a kid as good as Logie to win this thing.
Definitely, definitely. And you know, so, Ed, expectations are great. You know, you want it for your boy, you want it for yourself and everything, you know. And we all do for our families and so forth.
It makes you better.
Yeah, it does. But sometimes parents get so involved in expectations that they get pretty narrow-minded, you know, and kind of get blinders on there. And then sometimes, you know, who are you going to take it out on? I guess it's the coach.
I talked to Mark before the game tonight. I said, well, you probably feel a little heat. He smiles and, oh, yeah, it's there. I said, well, Coach, let me tell you, you won a lot of games before that kid showed up.
Yeah.
And you got to keep that in perspective,
That's
too.
That's right. You know, Mark was there. He's been there for 13 years at Morris and 8 years the head coach. Before that, he coached he was assistant to Bob Mulder. Now, Bob Mulder is a cousin to the great Kevin Mulder that played for Morehead State.
The all-time scoring leader, you bet.
Yes, and I'll tell you what, Bob Mulder was a very good, Mark told me tonight, he says, boy, I learned a lot of defense from Bob. Bob was an excellent coach. He lives in Fargo now, is outstanding man. They're very good friends yet.
And here we go, Zach Witt off the timeout with a minute 15 remaining in the first half.
Now, that thing's doing its job, that little press. Slowing them up a little bit. Now, if they can just stop Witt from penetrating it.
Schmidgall back to Boots. Inside a minute, Logie, triple team. Fabulous player.
Great touch.
He's hit 8 of 9 shots. He's got 16 points here in the first half.
You know, you're 6'10", you put the ball on the floor, and people say, oh, no, but he kind of lost it a little bit. He went down, dug it out. He's so quick with his hands. Look at those hands, so quick.
Andy Tate, he's the beneficiary of the scoring column of that play. And all of a sudden, it's a big lead for the Tigers. Fergie at the Levang. Carl, and he's fouled. That's going to be on Schmidgall.
Hillcrest going for the last shot here. I'm sure they're hoping they're going to get a 3 out of it.
In for the Comets, number 22, Joel Scheid.
Put Scheid in for Berge for offensive purposes.
Nice touch.
Ah!
Won't go. Levang in trouble. Gets it off. This is Olstead for three. Nice put back. It won't count. Selvig's follow will not count. So the Tigers will step to the locker room at intermission with a decisive lead. 42-24. The Morris Tigers, ranked number one in the state at 22-2, leading here at halftime. Let's go to Dana Mock.
Greg Preston, you get your hands full, don't you?
Yeah, we sure do. You know, we thought even the first quarter we came out and did some things pretty well. Kept it actually about 10. I think what really hurt us, I think we had it down to 7 or 8. We're moving the ball pretty well, good patience, getting good shots. And then they got a putback here on a missed free throw. They missed 2 free throws, got a putback, and that really hurt. Lead went up to about 18 in a hurry.
There's never any quit in the comments, is there?
There isn't. There won't be the next half either.
Thanks, Coach.
Greg Preston, and here's just play at both ends of the floor, Denny.
Oh, yeah. I wonder how many points out of the 78 points a game that this team scores, I wonder how many points he developed some way or other.
Created off the defensive end and then in transition.
Right.
And he's got the two perfect guards to complement that type of D in the paint.
The young man, Tate, there, number 10, as we watched him come down the floor, he's the cross-country champ for the last 2 years in the state of Minnesota. I mean, these kids are real athletes.
The Tigers losing to St. Agnes in last year's state championship game. They want another shot at the whole thing. They might get it. They lead at halftime in the semifinals of the 6A tournament here at Concordia. 42-24. We're back with more live Minnesota basketball coverage on DAY. Oh, the smiles of the tournament, they never go away. We started this thing, Denny, back in 1985. Is that right, Jim? It sure is. 1985 when Glenwood defeated Lake Park.
Okay, yes.
And remember, some of the great teams we've seen over the years here, Staples, of course, Lynn Peterson always brings a ball club here.
Oh, doesn't he? Yes.
How about Critchie's team in 87, the Hawley Nuggets?
Outstanding. I felt they were going to win the state. You know, they shot 72% and got beat in the game down the state. They got a little conservative, didn't take enough shots.
Then Bertha Hewitt over Breckenridge in the 88 game. Wasn't that a dandy? Long Prairie has come up with some phenomenal games. And the Tigers, their 2 losses this year, both on the road, and a team that you're going to see a little bit later here tonight, Minnewaska taking on Staples. They defeated this Morris Tigers ball club by 4. So hold your hat and stay tuned. We got another great one coming up.
The other little thing here is that New London Spicer, a bunch of sophomores and juniors last year, I believe Morris went overtime with them both times to beat them. And they were also in the state tournament last year. So we got another young team there down there in another region that people will be looking forward to be in the state tournament.
We're at halftime. The Tigers lead Hillcrest, and we're back with more in a moment. Logie unofficially has missed only 1 shot here in the first half, and there he is using the baseline very well, getting around the triple team, and has got great presence on the floor. And the field goal is just phenomenal, hitting 19 of 26.
That's just difficult to beat. There's no doubt about it. You know, Hillcrest isn't shooting that bad. You know, they could have just well had a couple more. They were right on the iron, but it's just whatever Morris, whatever they're doing is right all the time.
Olstead has got 8 for the Comets, and Logie with 16. He's 8 of 9 from the field tonight.
Ed and Dana, Olstead started with the 6 of the first 8 points, and So Morris goes out after him and really makes it difficult for him to get any more shots, because that's the type of team they've got. They got such quickness out there, they can go out and get those quick kids.
Ryan Prosser, who hit some big threes the other night, has yet to score. And he is very dangerous when he gets going at three-point land. And Nate Carl, as you mentioned, has got to come up and hit some shots. They're just not falling. Levang actually has played, I think, pretty well inside against Logie on the offensive end.
He certainly has.
We're at halftime. Tigers lead it. We'll be back.
Back for the second half. Morris leading 42-24. Mark, any concerns here for the second half?
Well, we got to keep playing hard because they're going to come at us. They played very well up here in the second half in the subsection game. So we got to keep playing hard, keep trying to get it into Kevin. He's had a good half, and Zach's penetration has been there, and the threes have been there. We got to keep her going. We can't let up.
Thanks, Mark.
No sense in coming this far and letting up, right, Coach?
Well, I think he remembers last year when Staples came back from 20 down and had a chance at the buzzer to win the thing. I'm so impressed with their athletes. They got such quickness. I mean, the guards out there, we know they're quick, but Logie is so quick. They've just got a fine team.
I got to take a real close look at this Minnewaska ball club. I don't know if this Tiger team's beatable. And they beat them by four. Is that going to be a great one?
Well, I'll guarantee you, Ed, they didn't play like they did the first half against Hillcrest and get beat. I'll guarantee you that. 19 for 26 at 73% from the field. That is amazing.
Logie, 8 of 9, and he's got 16. We've yet to see him at the free throw line.
You know, Coach Preston said he wanted to keep them down so they didn't take too many shots. And actually, he's probably 26 shots. I think he'd be fairly happy with that.
You betcha. Well, the Tigers, they will start it out here in the second half against the zone. He's human. Rasmus's shot is denied.
I like the idea that he had of using the board. Using the glass up there. It's a friendly glass. He just got it a little bit too hard.
This is a shooter's gym, is it not?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it is.
And a free throw by Asmus. It won't go. So the Comets will face a man-to-man, their first possession. Berge. Berge can play. Prosser has yet to shoot a three tonight. Levang on the base. Schmidgall comes off with it to Zach Witt. The save by Tate comes off to Olstead. Levang, Berge.
Nice pass.
They'll take it. Just get a few and see what happens, right?
That's what they're looking for. Nice job on the press.
Asmus can't get it to go. Where did that rebound come from?
Oh, did he leap?
Zach Witt, what an athlete.
Ed, when I saw his head up there, I thought, well, that had to be one of their 6'3 kids at least.
Oh, Logie with phenomenal touch.
That answers a question, doesn't it?
It certainly does.
Yes, I can shoot it from 15 too, guys.
Nice turnaround.
Yes, nice shot.
Olstead. Knocked out of bounds by Andy Tate.
Look at Andy Tate just stays after the ball all the time. That's just the way they're playing. I mean, it's going to be very tough to come back against a team that hustles like that.
Olstead.
passer lost the ball off his foot. Here's the nice passing by Hillcrest on the break. Olsted long down court. Levang saves it to Berge.
Yeah, that was beautiful.
Asmus on the putback of the missed shot. Berge's in trouble. Gets it off to Carl. Here come the Comets. Picked off by Zach Witt. To Logie. He's got 20. Prosser. He's fouled. Well, that wakes up the crowd a little bit, no matter what the score is.
Well, yeah, and it also wakes up Coach Preston. He's saying, hey, guys, we can't play this game against them. That's a pretty easy chore for the big guy to go up there and slam it, isn't it?
He saw the opportunity off the turnover and got hustling. Commanding lead, Selvig. And the Comets will maintain possession. They're 6, 7, 8, 9 deep on the baseline here at the Cobber Fieldhouse. Packed up to the top. They're parking 10 blocks away. Witt to Andy Tate. Nice pick by John Berge. Up to Florida. Scheid is fouled. That's going to be on Andy Tate. Now, Scheid can run the floor. Now, we've seen Hillcrest come out here in the second half. They're pushing the ball up the floor.
They really are. They had two of the best doing it there, Berge and Scheid. Berge came up with a steal down there and came out hard. But I just, I don't know if that's what they're going to want to do.
Berge. Nice touch. Berge, he's got 6. Still a commanding lead by the Tigers. Witt, curled away, the no-look pass. Could not be handled by Asmus.
It's called spacing, Ed. They were just too close together. There's no way you can react to a ball coming at you when it's that close together and it's got a sting on it.
Carl. Levang. He'll use the four. No wonder that tape was up on that glass.
Beautiful shot.
This is a good start for Hillcrest. And drills a 3.
What a way to answer a run, huh?
It's a 20-point lead for the Tigers. 4:28 remaining in the third, but a very fluid start for Hillcrest. They're not intimidated, but they are behind, and we'll be back. It is very rare that we have a score like this in this tournament, which is to suffice how good Morris is.
They have played tremendous basketball up to this time. They really have.
Carl. Scheid inside. Carl gets it. The turnaround. Nice touch over the big kid. Carl's got 4 on the night. Play with confidence. Stay aggressive. Dana, what are the kind of words we're hearing in the huddle there?
Greg Preston, same guy as if he was up by 20 or down by 20. Defensively, he wanted to switch to a 1-2-2 zone. A little safer that way, he felt.
Scheid draws the foul.
Scheid exploded to the bucket from the baseline down there. Berge gives him a nice pass up court. Tough to handle a kid that goes to the bucket like that.
Yeah, he's definitely got direction. Scheid, his 4th point tonight. Olsted will check in. We have not seen the Comets get carried away with three-pointers. What's your philosophy on that, Denny, when you get behind? When do they become an integral part of what you have to do?
Well, I think it is an integral part of the Comets game, but they just haven't been able to get them off because of Morris's quickness getting out there.
Levang, this is a nice rebounding flurry that the Comets have going on the boards, but...
In other words, what I'm saying, Ed, is that, you know, that they really shoot a lot of threes. If they can shoot them, they'll take them, because they're excellent three-point shooting game. It depends on what type of team you got, I guess. If you've got a team that can shoot them, you know, and you haven't been shooting them, you gotta go after it when you're down 20 points. I wouldn't just shoot threes all the time, but
Logan. Levang. The Comets.
Well, Hillcrest pinching Logie in there now. He's got a lot of body on him when he gets the ball, so it's throwing him off a little bit.
Shied. They're drawing everybody out of there. They want Shied to drive, and that one didn't work. They had three guys in the corner at the top of your screen trying to clear out for the two guards.
Yep, they tried to clear it out, but Logie stepped over and took care of business.
Tell you about his touch. He's hit three threes and two twos tonight.
He's an excellent athlete. I don't know what else Morris could do. I mean, they are just playing a magnificent basketball game.
Well, Mark Turgerson's got him tournament ready. There's no question about that. Berge covered up by Schmidgall and Olstead. And Boots is tied up by Levang.
Levang is sure working hard on the board, guys. I'll tell you, he is really pounding in there.
Shied. Olstead. Levang, why not? He draws the foul. Smart play. Logie doesn't foul out very often, but if he can get one on him, it isn't going to hurt.
This is so typical of the Hillcrest kids. They give that threat of a shot. Threat of a shot.
You mentioned that the other night.
Fake. Yeah, it's great. It's a great move. It's just a great fake, and then they put the ball on the floor and try to get their shot.
Well, it gives you a second chance.
You bet.
And Mike Levang, who's got eight, misses his first free throw. We're back with the championship game Friday night. 8 o'clock start. Two misses. For Levang.
Witt puts on a little exhibition out there, but uses it to his advantage. He's just a great ball handler. Well, there's one of the few passes that Morris is throwing away tonight. I see no letdown by the Morris team, though, because they're still hustling on defense, and you keep hustling on defense, you don't have a letdown.
Olstead up top. Prosser's first three of the night.
He can shoot him.
His first attempt and his first hit. That ball, Coach.
Very much of a ball handler with, I was going to say, very much confidence.
Logie called for double dribble. Mark Turgeson didn't see it. Levang. The defense.
There's
by the Tigers is something else.
He had him up in the air again. Logie's got those long arms. He reached out and got a piece of the ball.
Still a 17-point lead as we wind down the third quarter.
Got a nice
to be able to bring in a 6'5 guy off the bench, isn't it?
It Boots? Is.
He's a fine player.
Zach Witt tosses it away, a rare turnover again.
Yeah, he's had a couple here the second half.
Closing seconds here of the third quarter. 17-point lead for the top-ranked Morris Tigers. This is John Berge with the ball. Prosser just hit a three. Now they got Boots out on him. He'll challenge the line. Up top, shot. He's dangerous. That one won't fall. LeBang, the putback is rejected by Logie and a foul by Boots.
I'm very impressed with LeBang's work ethics in there, Ed. He's really going after the boards.
LeBang hits his first of three at the line tonight. Mark Torgerson telling me before the game that Logie 6'9", but has got 6'11 arms. He's got that wingspan that's something else.
Got a Phil Jackson wingspan.
Oh, Zach Witt almost at the quarter. And it's going to be a 15-point lead for the top-ranked Morris Tigers as we go to the fourth quarter. Staples and Minnewaska will be up next. The Tigers just 8 minutes away from advancing to the Minnesota 6A championship game, and we're back. We go to the final 8 minutes of the semifinals here tonight. Game one, Morris Tigers ranked number one. They lead by 15 over the Fergus Falls Hillcrest Comets. And Logie, two more. He has got 22 on the night.
Coach set that play up and it was just beautiful. There wasn't anybody close to him when he caught the ball and put it in. Kevin Logie, first half 8 for 9, second half 3 for 7. Hillcrest has had some more bodies on him in the second half.
From the start, you bet. Prosser up top to Carl. Man-to-man deep, Prosser again. Rasmus. Nothing there. Andy Tate, three-point play. He's going to the line. Foul is going to be on John Berge.
Well, those legs won him two state championships cross country, and he really exploded to the basket with that bucket.
To the line for the Tigers, number 10, Andy Tate, please shoot one.
Andy Tate with 15 on the night. Just a dominant performance here by the backcourt of the Morris Tigers, and that completes the three-point play. Dana?
Ed, Denny, I was in that Morris home at the end of the third quarter, and Mark Torgerson said that Fergus Falls Hillcrest was out scrapping us a little bit. 15-point lead heading into the fourth was not enough, according to him. He said work it around the outside because Hillcrest is sagging on Logie. Work around the outside, that'll open up Logie.
Logie with a fake one way and comes back the other.
Well,
he's
Dana,
got 24.
Listening. They're listening to him because they're really scrapping.
They are. They are playing hard, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
Carl. Prosser had the three and passed it up. Berge. Berge in the land of giants. Finds a way. Logie again. They cover him up. He's got 3 seconds in there.
Nice pass by Logie to Asmus up high, but his foot was in the lane yet.
So with 6:19 remaining in the game, it's the Tigers by 18, and we're back. You're watching Minnesota 6A semifinal action live on the Valley Sports Leader, WDAY. subsection 8 AA championship game in Detroit Lakes at halftime. Fergus Falls leading Moorhead 29-20. Otters have already defeated Moorhead three times this year. Here, we're in the fourth. It's an 18-point advantage for the top-ranked Tigers. Waiting in the wings, Staples and Minnewaska. Two coaches, John Starnes and Lynn Peterson. You need a calculator to figure out how many wins they've got.
They've got a lot. They've got a lot. They're both going to be at the 400 anytime.
Prosser. Pumping some life into the Hillcrest offense. Back to a 15-point advantage for the Tigers. The kick by Olstead. Credit the Tigers tonight. They've held Olstead quiet offensively.
That's that quickness. They know he can score, so they're out after him.
Zach Witt uses a left hand really well. Logie, oh. What hands?
Did he go high to get that ball?
Levang, nice outlet to Olstead. He'll get an easy oh, yes, he gets it. That's recognizing the floor. It's down to 13. 5:20 remaining. It's going to be a near miracle needed, but you never know.
They're really working that inside-outside game, and that's an excellent game. Defense can't do much.
Tate. Zach Witt. Nice move on the base. And Asmus, no, it's going to be out on Levang.
Oh, Levang's going after that board. He is really after it.
I think the Tigers, their guards show tremendous discipline of passing up open shots, knowing they got the big kid inside.
Very patient.
That's coaching, is it not?
Yes, it is.
Again, it'll stay with the Tigers. They've got it down to 4.5 minutes.
You got to give Hillcrest credit. They're playing some excellent defense here. I mean, this Morris team has got so much power from all over the place, and they're on the ball. That word scrappy, that's exactly what Hillcrest is, a very scrappy team. There's a patient.
Oh.
They waited until Logie got good position in there, and Hillcrest kids couldn't do anything about it.
Just another night at the office. He's got his average at 26. And Levang is going to get charged with a foul. Logie with 27 points. We're down to the 4-minute mark. Comets at 19-4 on the year, trying to make it happen. This is Prosser for three. Again, Logie controls the missed shot. Tigers milked over 90 seconds off their last possession. Andy Tate. Oh, they are just solid all the way around the lineup.
They keep coming at you. See, Hillcrest has got to score to be able to be effective, because then they can put that little press on, and then they can control it a little bit.
Greg Preston wants his team to finish strong, and he'll call the timeout with 3.5 remaining, and we'll be back. Morris in control. Staples and Minnewaska will be here next at the Copper Field House, and then we'll be back on Friday night for our Section 6A championship game and the winner to the state tournament. And as we mentioned a little bit earlier tonight, in case you just joined us, that new format is going to be highly celebrated this year as the Sweet 16 tournament. It's going to be in Minnesota.
Ed, I'm impressed.
The winner of the 6A, this section, Denny, will not have to play a double-A team in the state tournament until the semifinal round, if they win down there. So,
okay,
a very formidable chance from the representative of this section, I would think.
Very much so. Yes, that would be great. I was going to say, I'm really impressed with Hillcrest. I tell you, they got it down to 13 points, and then Morris kept the ball for a minute, finally got the ball to Logie for a three-pointer, and then Tate comes back and hits another three. So
Zach Witt, he did it all, but the behind-the-back was a little bit too much.
Yeah, I think he's a little bit frustrated in Hillcrest's quickness.
Levain for three. Won't go. 17 is the count. We're inside the three-minute mark. Logie, Witt from 15. Too strong, Logie again. I know that we have not seen a finer big man in the years of doing this tournament.
No.
Levain. Oh, Logie, big rejection. Nothing called and a nice put back by Selby. Still at 17. I understand that Zach Witt has just got a tremendous arm. Going to be a great throwing quarterback in that one-back offense for Runkle.
That wouldn't surprise me any. I'll tell you, he's a great athlete.
Logie out to Witt. They're going to milk it. We're down inside the two-minute mark. He set Logie up for the jam, but the foul came, and he may have gotten away with a little travel there.
I believe so.
Nice piece of ball handling by Zach Witt, but wait a minute now. One, two, oh, that'll do it.
Yeah, I'm going to have to talk to Terry Knopf and say maybe he's a little too quick for his reffing. He had the right idea, and he went in there, and they're going to get points out of it.
Logie. I got him unofficially for 30. I mean, he just had a night. So with a minute 43 remaining, Kevin Logie will sit down and he will be back here on Friday night. One of the most celebrated players in the state this year on the top-ranked Class A Tigers. He was the nuclear warhead for this team tonight. I guess I'm so amazed at how complete the Tigers are. And I really have to compliment Greg Preston and Hillcrest for really matching them in a number of phases of the game. They got out and got some transition buckets tonight. Levain got in and got some rebounds. If there's one thing this Hillcrest team was lacking tonight was a good shooting percentage in the first half.
You're so right with that whole thing, Ed. I'll tell you, we're sitting here and the second half, Hillcrest has played right with them.
Yes, they have. It's at 17, and Mike Levain off the bucket can get a three-point play, and he does. Well, that one won't go. Good quickness tonight shown by both ball clubs. Rasmus gets it back to Zach Witt. Witt over to Andy Tate. Tate has really been a three-point ace tonight. He's hit 4 3-pointers. You know, you talk about Logie's 30 points. What about those 3-pointers this outfit has hit? They've hit 5 3-pointers, 6 3-pointers as a team. Schmidtgall has hit 2 of them. Tate's hit 4.
It goes right along with you saying they're such a complete ball club. Yeah, they got guards that are quick, can shoot the three-pointers. Their front line can shoot the three-pointers, and their front line can really sky. They're very good jumpers. Big rebounders at 6'3", 6'5", comes off the bench. Excellent team.
Zach Witt chipping in 10 tonight. This will be his second free throw. And Levang comes away with the rebound. We're inside a minute remaining in the ball game. And it comes off to Asmus. Asmus getting a little sloppy. Selvidge going to have a shot at a bucket. Too strong. Asmus again. So we're down to the final 40 seconds. Donovan in for the Tigers. That's going to be a foul on Levang, and that will send Asmus to the line shooting 1-1. So we have not had the drama and the excitement in this first game tonight that we're so used to in this tournament, but what we have seen is some superior talent on the high school level.
Very much so, and Hillcrest does not have to feel bad. They played an excellent basketball game. In fact, as we said to start the game, if some of those shots would have gone, they were right there. They would have been right with Morris at halftime.
And Jeremy Stock comes in for the Tigers. And also checking in, Ryan Nelson. So Mark Torgerson is going to unload the bench here. Ryan Donovan is in. Free throw by Asmus is good. He's got 4 on the night. And also checking in for Hillcrest. Carl back in the ball game. And Asmus sits down. And John Huebner is in for the Tigers. So Boots is the only regular on the floor for the Tigers right now. Hillcrest trying to get something going. Eric Ugrud makes a nice shot on the bucket on the side court. Down to the closing seconds. These Tiger players, they want a piece of the action, do they not, Coach?
Oh, don't they?
Oh, there's a nice move inside.
Nice drive on the baseline.
That
there.
Was a dandy move, and the Morris Tigers score with Ryan Donovan putting it up and in, and that'll do it. As the Morris Tigers, with a overwhelming performance here tonight, with a 75-55 win over the Hillcrest Comets. Morris goes to 23-2. Fergus Falls, Hillcrest Academy ending the season at 19-5. So a very dominant showing by Kevin Logie.
Both teams playing excellent basketball. It's just that Morris had just a few too many weapons.
Let's go to the side court. Dana Mock is with the kid who unofficially put in 30 tonight, and also the backcourt ace in Zach Witt. Dana?
Kevin, you were supposed to win this game. Nobody thought that Hillcrest would upset you. Was it tough to prepare for him, to get emotionally ready to play?
Yeah, we just had to go over. We had film to the team, and we got, you know, we watched some films and had to watch the guys. You know, we knew what guys we had to stop, and that's what we did. You know, we came to do our job, and that was to win, and that's what happened.
Seeing their tallest player was 6'3", you had to know you'd kind of have a big day tonight?
Well, I didn't know. You know, I just wanted, whenever there's Wildcat Garden, you know, I just take advantage as much as I can.
Does the challenge at times come to just play as a team, and because you have an 18, 20-point lead so often, to make sure you just finish the job and stay fundamentally sound throughout the game?
Exactly. Like that happened last year. We were up to Staples, you know, by 18, 20 at halftime, and they came back and got within two. And that was all last year. We'd get up big at halftime, and we'd end up giving it up, you know, and the team come back. We knew we just had to keep putting on the pressure and keep winning as much as we could.
Evan, congratulations. Good luck Friday.
Thank you.
Zach Witt joins us. Zach, was the cheer at the end of the game for you or your younger brother, Forrest?
I can't quite figure that one out. I think it was for my brother, but he's got a fan club down there.
Pleased with this performance and your win over Hillcrest because you were supposed to win.
Yeah, we were supposed to win. We played a little sloppy. I had a lot of turnovers, but
you have to get better by Friday against either Staples or Minnewaska. Against Staples or Minnewaska, you have to raise your level of play even more.
Oh, yeah, we'll raise our level of play. I think we usually play to the level of our competition, so, but.
Nice game, Zach.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, thanks, Dana, at courtside with a couple of key players, and Mark Torgerson, a familiar face of our coverage of the tournament here of the section. Mark, congratulations. Nice job tonight. Kids played really hard, even with a big lead.
Yeah, thank you, and we had to because Hillcrest did not give up, and boy, that's one of the scrappier teams we've played, and real quick, and as Zach said it, we turned the ball over a little more than we're used to, and we'll have to take better care of the ball on Friday night.
Well, I tell you what, you're talking about turnovers. What I saw was some phenomenal ball handling in the backcourt by your kids and some nice three-point shooting by Andy Tate, who finished with 19.
Yeah, Andy, they were really collapsing on Kevin after the early good start for Kevin, and Andy and Corey both, I thought, came through with threes. We have not shot a lot of threes in the last few ball games, but it's good to, at tournament time, that we have that weapon.
Their pressure at any time, giving any problems, that three-quarter, half-court zone pressure, I think they probably did that to take you out of your rhythm a little bit, make you work.
Well, I think they had to try to keep the ball out of Kevin's hands by making us work out here, and it worked a few times, but seemed like we got a 20-point lead, and then they made a mini run, and at least we had the answers, and you always don't at this tournament time, so we have to be very careful about that.
What is the attitude of your big kid, Kevin Logie? I mean, he came in here tonight a labeled player, has been all year long. He hits his first seven shots, 8 of 9. Confidence of the whole team comes up, and you're on a roll. I mean, he really answers to the call.
That's really important for us to get Kevin started early, because then it opens up the outside, and Andy and Corey came through. But Kevin, he plays the ball game the way it's meant to be played. He plays with, he's loose out there, he has fun, he has great moves, it's really good to also see him making his free throws.
Mark, we're seeing a lot of familiar names, and you were at the state tournament last year. How hard did these kids work this year on the offseason?
Well, they worked very, very hard. Zach and Kevin were on the select team, and they had a lot of traveling, and we didn't play a lot of team ball together, except we had a late summer tournament in St. Cloud where we got a chance to play teams like Moorhead and Hopkins and had real good games and actually won those, and I think that gave us confidence, maturity-type confidence as a team to say, hey, we can maybe play at that next level, and I think the incentive in the Sweet 16 to play AA teams kept this team working hard. We had a couple times where we were real flat, and our loss to Minnewaska woke us up.
Well, let me ask you about that. You got Staples and Minnewaska coming up in our coverage next. You lost to Minnewaska, one of two losses on the year by 4 points. Would the kids like another shot at them?
Oh, yeah, we did get a chance to play them after that, but still, that would be great, two conference teams. The kids know each other very, very well on those two teams. They went to camps together, and we gotten to know the Staples kids pretty good, too. But
who do you match up better with?
Well, both teams are very solid defense. Staples can play a little bit more man-to-man and zone, and Minnewaska is strictly a zone, but boy, they play it probably as well as anybody in the state. I think that you know, either team, we're going to have to play a little bit better than what we played tonight, but that's being pretty selfish as a coach when you win by 20 points.
Mark, congratulations. We will see you on Friday night. Your team certainly deserves to be here. A great run.
Thank
for you.
You
at 23-2 on the year. Kevin Logie at 6'10", leads the way with 31 points tonight as Morris defeats Fergus Falls Hillcrest 75-55. The Tigers will be back at the title game on Friday night, and we'll decide the next team.